Hello, I'm Woodland Spirit.
And I'm Loppy Lena.
And welcome to the show, episode 16.
And it's been absolutely ages.
Yes, it's been absolutely a long time. I'm just actually trying.
Finally got me back.
Yes, obviously, the previous things we've done together, we've had huge, tremendous mic problems, to be honest.
Yes.
Or, shall I say, very unoptimal mic setups.
Yeah.
The last show we actually did was back in May last year.
Wow. Does it even feel like it's been that long,
That's
really?
15 months since.
Gosh.
Yes. And
that is
so
long.
And, oh.
Is that the last time I played on the Xbox?
No, we did. We did do a recording that I managed to screw up. And then I had the paddy with us and we kind of stopped.
Yeah, and then it kind of, you ended up doing everything.
But I've always had a huge issue with the mic setups. We've finally got a proper mic.
Yay!
A proper mic that can do both of us at the same time.
Yeah.
Oh, horsey!
Right, so I want to do a settlement round here.
Settlement. So, we've actually started a whole new world because it's been a long time and there's been like millions of updates to Minecraft since
we've last played this. Which we've now got to kind of get used to.
Yes, I'm trying to remember all the buttons because it seems like ages since we last played this.
Well, considering I'm normally the donut who forgets everything, I've kind of remembered them buttons.
Well, that's enough, I guess. So, hang on, what is that, of course? Wait a moment. Empty map.
Where's the map? Don't you normally have a map to start?
Right. Oh! Hang on! I think this is something they've added recently. It's that you must craft an empty map, but you gotta actually use it to lock it into the grid place map world area. So that's kind of useful. So you can create a load of maps in one area, then just sort of gradually spread them out as you go through. So yes, 15 months since we last played.
Probably 15 months since we last done this as well.
It's 15.
You'll have to excuse me with my voice. I think I'm getting a bit
of
a cold.
Yeah, bit of a cold. I'll try and do my best to interpret any.
Yeah.
Any. So yes, 15 months. 2 E3s have passed. Lots of games have been released. Some new consoles are coming. And apparently new Call of Duty's just come out.
Boo.
Sorry, just a big yawn there. So yes, 2 E3s have passed.
Which we've watched both of them.
Yeah, we watched both of them. We didn't really report much on them.
No.
Obviously lots of games during those E3s. The most recent E3 of this year was probably the pendant console. Well, actually, it wasn't for Sony, but it was for Microsoft. The pendant consoles,
I should say
the Xbox One S has been released. Obviously, just a refined version of the current Xbox One. Obviously, in the pendant Project Scorpio, which
you're quite looking forward to.
Well, I'm personally myself looking forward to, because it sort of cements how I knew the Xbox would go, to be honest. Because, obviously...
Although, we have got a pending holiday around about the time it comes
out.
So.
Yes, thanks for the reminder. prior to the Xbox One PS4, there's been what would be termed as console generations.
Yeah.
And to be honest, I think the whole term, the whole aspect of generation is now effectively dead. Because, obviously, you've got...
I'm just flattening an area, by the way.
Carry on. you've got...
Just in case you wondered what I was doing. Going backwards and forwards.
Right, I kind of got it. We've got, let's just as an example, you've got the likes of Steam. It's a platform, basically.
Yeah.
A platform that runs on hardware. you upgrade your hardware, the platform still works, and you still have all your games. This is an aspect that's been missing from the console world. And to me, I think it's a very good thing, because basically you can build up a vast library of games and be confident. I mean, they could potentially shoot themselves in the foot with this one. You can be confident that all your game collection will carry over to future hardware iterations, effectively. And to me, that is a good thing, because obviously, well, it's backward compatibility, basically. It's it has been dabbled with in past generations. PS2 could play PS1 games. PS3, a certain model could play PS2 games. The Wii could play GameCube games, and the Wii U can play Wii games, and the entire Game Boy consoles the whole backward compatibility aspect was entirely drilled into us. Also, Xbox 360 had to an extent original Xbox compatibility. And now, obviously, the Xbox One is now backward compatible to 360. And Sony is Sony's taking the angle of trying to get everyone to buy all their game collection again, which I think is cheap and not particularly good practice. But no, there you go. I'm just trying to work out where to go. So obviously, with the whole generation, the whole question of backward compatibility is no longer a thing. It's gonna be a standard feature of new hardware, and that seems to be where the angle that Microsoft and Sony are going. So in effect, console generations are no longer a thing no more. The whole PlayStation and Xbox is now an ecosystem akin to the likes of obviously Steam, and to a certain extent the whole mobile phones. You either have Android or iOS as a platform, and the hardware you run on it runs on. So to me, this is actually a very good thing. You haven't seen the Nintendo Switch trailer, have you? Okay.
Must be a little bit behind on things.
Right, let's see.
You're showing me
it. Yeah, I'm going to try and find the trailer for you. It's starting to get dark just as well. We've got it on, Peaceful, that's it.
Until I've got the house, and then we'll...
Yeah, we'll make it more interesting with other stuff. Right, so...
That's because it's on mine, and I don't like creepy colours coming out on mine.
Right.
Oh, my chuffing voice.
So...
Excuse me.
Was it really 2 weeks ago? Right.
Okay, show him the video.
Yep, I'm showing the video. The mic will probably pick up the sound of this. So, you've got, obviously, got the guy playing there. Yep, he's just happily playing there. You got the logo. And then he goes over and takes off two like mini controllers, slots them into a tablet like thing, and then walks off with it.
Ooh.
Right.
Okay.
And that's the basis of it. It's this whole tablet thing with little side controllers in. That's the basis
that's
of.
That's quite.
Now, it's different, definitely. But whether people will actually buy into it is another thing, because people are already making comparisons to the tablets, basically, Android and iPads. Whatever format tablets there is on the market. Obviously, it's game and dedicated. I've never seen mountainscapes like that before.
That's what I like about Minecraft. Each time you go,
yeah, well, each different. World you build is different.
Yeah,
you create. It's obviously a gaming oriented tablet. I mean, it's not gonna be high spec, but Nintendo never necessarily relied on high spec systems for their games. Basically,
Nintendo's just a kid's machine.
I think a lot of people feel that Nintendo's is just a kid's machine. I mean, it's one of the selling points. And actually, if I was to be completely honest, I think the only reason the Wii sold so well
is because
it appealed to non-gamers. There's more non, because it's like motion control. It's no complicated controls or anything. You just wave at the bows. To me, that appealed to non-gamers, and of course, there's a lot more non-gamers than there is gamers.
Yeah, that's true. It's more of a family thing, isn't it?
Well, kind of Nintendo is a bit of a family thing.
Because I think the whole Wii might be better for our little boy, but he is starting to kind of grasp the control, and
we have got him a little controller for a Christmas present.
Which I will point out. I found first.
Yes. You found it first.
So we bought him a little one because he's got such little hands.
Yeah, little hands. It's always been kind of a little gripe with controls. They are relatively big for little hands.
And that's what he kind of struggles with.
Yes.
Because he's got tiny hands. He's only four and...
Yeah, he's got small hands. So. Man, I've never really had big hands either, really.
So I found this and I was like, ooh, I must get him one of them.
A little controller. So we've gotten one of them for Christmas. Shh, keep it a secret. Shh. So, anyway, what were we talking about again? Nintendo and game console and more of a children-oriented thing. I mentioned we being more of a... it appealed to non-gamers.
Yeah.
Where was I going with
this? I do kind of like the little concept of it, but we've got tablets again.
Well, so it's...
We use our tablets different to what we use the games console.
Yeah, I suppose there's potentially this covers.
That's a bit low.
Yeah, I think you need to remodel that house a bit.
Yeah, but it's just a basis.
It's a basis. Okay. It's a tablet, and I think a lot of people are only going to see the tablet. But my one thing that I think is going to be an absolute nightmare is those, like, mini controllers.
Yeah.
Either slotting them in and out of the sides is going to ultimately break them all the time.
Yeah, they'll probably get really brittle and...
Or they're just going to keep going missing.
Which in our house, considering everything goes missing, it will probably go missing.
Thanks to little hands.
Yeah.
But on top of this, I think there's been concept work of little...
Okay, is that a new thing on the treasure?
Trap chest.
Where's the treasure chest?
It's you had it. Go on. We're gonna have to find everything again, aren't we?
Yeah.
You are. Ah, no! You need to be at the crafting table.
Of course.
Don't. There you go. There's your chest.
Thank you. See, it shows you. Oh,
how long we've done us.
Three.
Right, you created three.
I only created one.
Well, you just put them in the chest.
I am going to. That's what I'm wanting to do. Make a chest.
Make a chest. Right.
I need to find some stone.
Why you go digging for stone?
Yeah, no.
You've got us lost off again. Oh, the little controllers. There's been concept that games will have custom mini controllers.
Yeah.
And I could see in whether they'll be essential or not to the game, I don't know.
Yeah.
But I can imagine items on eBay and whatnot with a little footnote, missing controller. You get distracted by the flowers.
Yeah, sorry.
Yes. So yes, the Nintendo Switch console. Nintendo's next gimmick.
Yeah.
Whether it's a gimmick will work or not remains to be seen. I'm not ultimately convinced.
Mind you, I bought last year a 3DS again, didn't I?
Oh, we had a DS again. No. You quickly got bored of it, didn't you? And you didn't use the 3D feature either.
No.
I remember trying.
And we really only bought it as like a trial for our son as well, and he didn't really.
He didn't kind of get on with us.
He's just got a new tablet instead.
He's got a tablet now and all the various little children orientated games.
Phonics. Which parents will know about.
If any parents are listening, watching.
Phonics.
Yeah.
Loads of games on Phonics.
Phonics is apparently a big thing, game-wise.
For him. Well, it's learning.
So, have you actually created tools as well?
Okay, I've just found some random bits.
Meat? What? That's meat.
Yeah, random. And I found a random brick.
No, that's wool.
Oh, wool. Well, I found a random
So, wool. If you're wool and meat, that's possibly lamb you've picked up.
Ooh!
So a sheepy's copped it probably.
Well, we need to find some more wool then. We'll have some. Then at least we'll start making a bed.
A bed, yes. I actually got one bit of wool there.
Oh, you've got one bit. How many do we need?
There's not three.
I think so. We'll put them in the treasure chest.
The chest.
Yeah.
Right. Quick move. And then quick and apple. Yeah, we'll call it
raw mutton.
What?
Raw mutton.
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 Mutton. So that's not lamb, it's mutton.
Mutton dressed as lamb is lamb.
Oh, lamb.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll shut up then. Horsey, black horsey, hello. Yeah. I know about the horses.
Mutton dressed as lamb.
Mutton dressed as lamb.
It's like old sheep.
Old sheep. Mutton dressed. So it's mutton. No, never mind. The logistics of meat.
Why do you think people say mutton dressed as lamb?
But mutton is a sheep, not a lamb, though, is it? That's what I'm trying. That was trying to say. It's not lamb meat. It's like sheep meat.
Yeah.
If that makes sense.
Still the same.
But one's lamb and one. No, yeah, never mind. One's all, one's you, right? Okay. Oh, look at that over there.
Oh wow.
Anyway,
we've
yes.
We kind of gone right.
Where were we?
I don't know. You can tell we haven't done this for a while. Awesome.
I'm sure we usually keep more on topic than this than we have done in the past.
I think it's because we haven't done it for ages.
Hey, my word.
So you was on about... Oh, horsey.
I was on about... Oh, horsey.
Actually, the last time we actually did this... And the recording messed up was when the spider jumped out on me.
Yeah, we had a spider
jump. That was the last time. Was it really that long ago?
Yes, it was that long ago. that was... I really wish I hadn't messed that up. I really wish I hadn't messed that up. Anyway,
I haven't even made myself a saw. Anything to chop with.
Tools. You need tools.
Yeah.
Always need tools in a new world. So, anyway, going back to me notes.
Oh, you made notes?
Yes, I actually made notes this time.
Oh, you're so much more prepared than I am.
Yes. So, in terms of what have you been playing lately?
I've been playing mainly I'm just concentrating here, mate.
I'll
bring my lamp on in a minute.
Oh!
I'm concentrating. Yeah. I've been playing mainly on the tablet again because we've just got a Samsung Galaxy.
The one, the Samsung Galaxies. Yes. The one, won't burst into flames, yeah. Anyway.
So I've like rediscovered my games on that.
So
again.
Things like Simpsons Top Down. Oh, hello.
Oh, wow.
And you've been doing.
I found a little
tiny.
Game
that's a long way down.
My Tiny Tower, I've rediscovered that again. A little game called My Cafe, but it depends how long I get into that.
So that's like a time management game, My Cafe.
Yeah, I just keep looking for random games all the time because I get a bit bored.
Okie dokie. I'm just quite in awe by all this. I've just found random.
But then it's like I've been like doing a lot of reading as well, though, haven't I?
Yeah.
I finally discovered e-readers.
Yes, e-readers. You were quite opposed to it, then you just kind of put it on your phone for one time. It was just so convenient for you, wasn't it?
Oh yeah, now I'm always reading.
Always reading. Right. Yeah. So yeah, that's your current games.
I mean, I've like still played my little games on Steam because like you had that Plantera that was good. I enjoyed.
Yeah, enjoyed Plantera. Yeah. There's a vast amount of videos covering Plantera on my channel.
Yeah,
if you're curious to what it is, just search
really,
Plantera.
Really good little game. Passes the time away.
So, anything else, or is that more or less?
I've gone through it. I'm just trying to keep doing Hercules 5.
Oh, the Hercules.
The Hercules games, whatever they're called.
Yeah, I think they're all subnoded with a subheading or something.
Yeah, but I've been trying to do a lot of them, but it's finding the time at the moment, and then I kind of forget.
Oh, snow blocks.
Oh, wow.
Natural snow blocks at that.
Make an igloo.
I think you can make an igloo actually. Igloo.
That might be what he keeps saying, igloo.
Igloo, could be.
Igloo.
Yeah, our little boy keeps saying igloo. have absolutely no idea what it is.
So it's something to him then.
So these are actually all ice structures.
I need to get one more, don't I?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, more stone. So these are actually all ice structures.
Oh, wow. You've been playing quite a lot.
I've been absolute mess of in terms of gaming habits because, obviously running the YouTube channel, I've gone through phases of desperately seeking out new releases and new games. So I've actually had a huge mass collection.
Yeah.
On the go. But I've actually calmed down a little bit and I've at the moment I'm playing believe it or not, Gears of War 4.
Oh yes.
Obviously there's a few car games I play with the little one.
And the little one is absolutely mad, and I don't know how long's that game been out, and we all of a sudden discovered it.
The Hot Wheels. Game. I never
because
even knew it existed.
Mad on Hot Wheels.
The Hot Wheel cars, and of course, there's like a Hot Wheels game which I don't think is much flash, to be honest. But
he loves it.
It's Hot
and it's
Wheels.
An easy game for him,
yeah, so. It's a way for him to get to grips with.
I've got loads of. Am I missing something? Am I missing something?
Have you by any chance been digging gravel?
Ah, oh, poop, I bet I have.
You've been digging gravel, not stone. Cobblestone. It's a difference.
No wonder
they look
blooming easy.
Right. Yes. It's
a blonde moment for me. There's loads there. I could have just gone
loads over there. It's been a good starting point for him
learning controls.
I think he's kind of there's probably just the hand coordination from getting used to seeing what he's controlling and vice versa.
But he has got proprioception problems, so
help him.
Yeah,
could actually help him. So we'll leave that on that note. I've been playing Gears of War 4, recently released. I've been playing a lot of Gears, and there's obviously a few people I play with
When you can all get
online, when we can all get together. But Judgment almost destroyed that.
Nearly, yeah.
Gears 1, 2, and 3. I'm sure people who are familiar with the series know the Gears games only too well. Gears 1, 2, 3.
I did all that and it was blooming gravel.
Yes, it's gravel. It was gravel.
Duh.
Gears 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah. And I just leave you to them games.
Yep. Developed by Epic. Obviously built up the games, built up a rule book.
Yeah.
Introduced a horde mode. And everyone loved us. Well, most people. I'd say just say most people, because obviously everyone not loved it, but most people loved us. Mm-hmm. Obviously, me and my group of friends loved playing it as well.
Yeah.
People Can Fly. Today they have a dabble with the franchise.
Aye.
Created Gears of War Judgment.
Uh huh.
Single player game, relatively decent.
Yeah.
Multiplayer aspect, completely and totally peed on.
Yeah.
But the worst offender, they removed Horde mode.
Ooh.
And they replaced it with a mode called Overrun.
Right.
It was an interesting experiment, but it was no replacement for Horde. And that, well, it almost fractured the group, because we all kind of stopped playing during the Judgment. But of course, Gears of War comes along. We're all more or less back into the series, providing we all can all get on.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's been playing Gears of War 4. Probably a lot of videos to go up in relation to that over time.
I better put that flint in, or else I don't want to.
Yeah, put the flint in the kit in this.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to be carrying. No.
Especially when we're in a wood hut. Is it, what's it?
It's flint and steel.
Yeah.
That's what it's called. It's flint and iron. Ingus, iron bar.
Yeah, well, we don't want to risk it.
We don't want the hut
after that time when you burnt down my
deck.
I will never ever forgive you for that.
Although I am quite annoyed, as I soon learned out a long time after that you can just waft flames to put them out. You didn't have to use water.
Ah, oh well.
So the deckin was in cinders.
Obliterated.
Hey, you ended up using different coloured wood, made it look more interesting.
Yes, but that's still not the point.
Yes, anyway, so Gears of War 4.
I'm starting to get the flow now.
Yeah, that's good. Gears of War 4. I've been playing a fair bit of Elite Dangerous, so I've streamed that a few times.
Yeah.
I'm currently lost in the middle of nowhere. Well, I'm not lost, but I'm in the middle of nowhere.
Engage.
Yes, that. About 10,000 or so light years away from civilized space. We haven't got a bed yet, have we?
No.
We need two beds as well.
We do
and
need two
I
beds.
Need to. Can't get too far, can I?
No.
Really.
I need some more wood. Because I've used all my wood in the burner.
I've been playing.
To create.
I've been playing Gems of War.
Yeah.
There's one achievement to get left on that, and it's a very, very grindy achievement.
Oh.
The achievement is to forge a mythic troop.
Right.
Which requires however many duplicates of legendary troops.
Right.
But of course, the lower the level of troops starts out with, the more duplicates of that troop. Yeah, I heard. The more duplicates of that troop you have to have, so
which actually I have to say it's bonfire night here in the UK.
In the UK tomorrow, so if you hear any
fireworks going on,
vague bangs while recording, then that's why. Nothing to do with bottoms.
And if you need to know what bonfire night is, just research on.
Just Guy Fawkes night, you'll soon find it. We're kind of celebrating the terrorist, in other words, but that's another story.
A failed terrorist,
but you do wonder if he was onto a good thing sometimes.
Oh, definitely.
But anyway. Where was I? Oh, Gems of War, very grand achievement still to go, so that's been minorly tedious.
Yeah.
And I'm kind of slowly getting into a game called Mordheim Mordheim.
Mordheim.
I think it's pronounced Mordheim.
Right.
You pronounce.
Okay. Okay.
Well, I've actually been pronouncing it Mordheim. I'm using the D as dime, time, dime.
Mordheim.
But I think it's Mordheim. But anyway, Mordheim, City of the Damned. I've already done two streams of this game, but to be honest, those two sessions are rubbish.
Yeah.
First time I muted me, I had myself on mute, so it's kind. It's going through the tutorials. If you went to read a bit, then it's still doable.
Yeah.
But it's pants.
You need to get mining because I need some iron.
You need some iron.
Just do some shearing.
Right. We'll tackle that at some point.
Yeah.
I need to find my way back to you.
That's what I need to do. The big thing to put the up on
the what?
Top.
The beacon.
Yeah, I'll let you do that then. Just use your map to find me. Oh, you're not that far
away. I'm not that far away. I've been keeping rough tracks.
You're just across the pond.
Across the pond. Mordheim. City of the Damned. Obviously, did two streams. The first one, I was muted.
Yeah.
The second attempt, it was like my first attempt at the real game. So
you can see me.
Yeah, I can see it. It's well lit. Mm-hmm. The second time was kind of ropey because it was the first real game, but I sat last night playing a bit more and I think I'm starting to get the proper hang of it.
So what's that game again?
Mordheim.
Yeah, which game is it? Because you play that many. I kind of lost track of which games you've played and which games you haven't.
I'm not sure you've seen us play it.
I might not have done.
You probably haven't seen us really playing it, so you'll have to watch us. But for those who are curious, it's an XCOM style game, and if you don't know what XCOM style
game. You made me jump then!
Did I? Oh, sorry. Do I look like a mass murderer or something?
Yeah, just peeking around.
Peeking around the door. it's an XCOM style game.
Boop.
And if you don't know what XCOM is, look it up.
Yeah.
It is actually a relatively good game. If you like that sort of strategic type games, it is really good for that. Mordheim sort of builds on that sort of style game. I suppose it's good XCOM set in medieval times, if you like. I'm actually starting to get to grips with it properly, so I'm probably going to do a future proper stream. Yes, because I am starting to get proper grips with it. It's not one you can quickly pick up. You do need to invest a little, like an hour or so, like sort of going through the various bits of tutorials, understand what's going on. But it is really good. So far, when you get the hang of us. There's one other game. I actually did a stream of this on Monday night for Halloween.
Oh, gosh,
it's
yes.
called The Trap. Yeah. The reason I want to bring this up is because it is a really, really good gaming experience, but only if played under the right circumstances.
Yeah.
I've come to the conclusion of this after playing it the Monday night. I fortunately played it under the right circumstances, and it is a very good gaming experience, in my opinion. But you have to play it. You have to set aside 2 hours.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a narrative, an interactive narrative, let's just say.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's a proper genre or not, but I need to catch up on different types of genres. It's a narrative. It's about 2 hours long.
Yeah.
It's between 1 and 2 hours long, depending on how deep you read into the various notes and whatnot laying about.
Which you should really read as
you
go along.
It advises you to play in a dark room with a headset on.
Yes.
I say this is totally correct.
Yeah.
Play it in the dark room or as dark as you can get it.
Yeah.
Because I started the computer monitor on monitoring the Steam stream, even though I kept forgetting I was actually streaming, playing the game. I had my headset on, but I think a suitable 5.1 surround system would be just as effective.
Yes.
The idea is just to immerse yourself in the game and then play through the whole game non-stop for the 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, seriously, by the time I got to the end of the game, I was close to tears.
Now, I can vouch for that. Now, I heard you scream.
Yes, it gives you frights.
And you was literally in tears when you spoke to me. I in all the gaming you've played, I have never, ever
It is a really moving... Well, I think you ultimately have to try and draw your own conclusions from the game. But it is really moving.
I would never, ever,
you ever... You would have nightmares. You would have nightmares. That seriously, the fright bits alone.
I would never be able to play the basic
premise of the game is you are a mother... Your little,
and that's another reason why
it actually connected with us on that level as well.
Yeah.
Your little boy has ran into a theme park and you go in looking for him.
Yeah.
Well, in this theme park, it has a bit of a bad history about it.
Yeah.
And I will leave it at that because the rest... Oh, that's another thing as well.
Yeah.
To make it a complete experience... Try and go into the game knowing as little about it as possible.
Yeah, right.
Because I think if I played through it again, it wouldn't have the same effect. Because I played it through totally first experience of the game.
Yeah.
Not knowing anything about it at all. And I think that's the most effective way to play.
And that's probably why you're not actually saying really that much about it.
I don't want to give too much away. But I would seriously say if you are curious about a game called The Park... It's made by a company called Funcom.
Yeah.
It's available on Steam, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4.
A small company, would you say?
They've been going since last century.
Yeah.
So.
But still more of a smaller one than yeah.
It's not like a massive studio, but they probably are doing well for themselves. Yeah, Let's just say that.
Yeah.
If you're curious to what the game is, if you want to try it,
follow
those instructions,
and
you will get the absolute best out of the game.
Yeah,
I've come to that conclusion, I think that kind of rounds up recently play what for was, me.
Yeah.
Yes. Gears of War 4. My opinions on it. That's what I kind of noticed. Considering a recent game, I think, to be perfectly honest, Gears of War 4 erases the mistakes that Judgment has made. I would say it is in very good hands in the Coalition, with the Coalition. They have understood what made the original games what they are, and they've followed through with that with Gears of War 4.
Yeah.
Some say that playing it safe, and I say they have had to play it safe to try and repair the damage that Judgment has done. So, to me, it gets a thumbs up. Everyone I play with would want to play Horde with each other.
Yeah.
It's getting everyone to go at the same time, so that's a plus in itself.
And you all want to play it?
We all want to play it.
So I think that's the first game in a long time, isn't it?
That we've all wanted to play it together. Yeah, this generation's been a bit funny with me, to be honest, so far. I mean, games are impressive. It hasn't really been a game that's totally absorbed us.
Yeah.
Maybe a little dangerous to an extent.
Yeah. Engage.
Yes, engage. That's the FL. No.
I only know that.
FSD drive. I was trying to think of abbreviation.
The only reason why I know that is because how many times do I hear it?
Yes. Well, when you're traveling from system to system on a long journey, I didn't even count the number of systems I've traveled to.
It's a history lesson. History.
What?
Geography. Whatever lesson for our son? You do keep kind of telling him astronomy lesson?
Astronomy. You got to be careful astronomy. Between astrology and astronomy. I think it's astronomy.
Astrology's
astrology is zodiac, the sorry. is the pretentious crap. astronomy, yeah, cuz
astronomy.
Yeah. Astronomy. That is definitely the correct pronunciation. Astronomy.
Astronomy.
I don't even realise I was saying it like that.
Astronomy. Now I've lost where I am.
Look at the map.
Oh, there's a sheep there. And there's a hole there as well. Is that where you went?
No, I may have uncovered that hole. I don't remember.
I think I should be the other way.
Yeah, well, you're currently there.
There's me house. Oops.
So, yeah, this generation's been of... Oh, actually, there was one game that did capture me for a bit.
Okay.
What?
What's that? I don't know. I'm going to go, what's okay.
What?
Carry on.
Oh, sorry.
What
game was it? Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare.
Of course.
I played that loads on the first one.
Yeah. Sunflower. And with the little boy Forza Horizon 2, and he wants 3.
Yeah, he likes the car games.
He does love the car games. Not likes, loves them.
Yeah, it's always cars on before bedtime.
Yep. And then he has story time.
And then story time. That's the reason for random racing car game streams. It's because it's that little session before bedtime.
Yeah.
Usually.
You need to kind of record when he's with you, because sometimes it's quite...
It's very cute, but obviously sometimes he gets himself into trouble as well at the same time, which you have to be careful of. But anyway. So, I think we've...
Our random silliness of our first show.
I think we've covered all the notes.
Woo!
I don't think there's anything else of specific note in terms of recent release games, unless you want to talk about FIFA 17.
Oh, God, no. Why on earth would I talk about FIFA 17?
They're point taken. Call of Duty.
That's even something worse. Point. I don't know which is worse.
FIFA or... Well, they're both the same recycled copy and paste games.
Yeah.
By different companies that just seem to want the money grab.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of money grab, if you don't know this, it means it's all over the news, Activision have released the latest Call of Duty on Windows 10 as well.
Yeah.
But it's not Play Anywhere. The Play Anywhere, where you buy on X1 or and play on the other. So, basically, they're trying to money grab by... potentially forcing you to buy two different versions.
Which game is it though? My mother has turned around and said is that Battlefield?
Maybe Battlefield 1.
Yeah, it might be that. Because my mother's quite a
shooter. Quite big John shooter. On top of that, if you buy the Windows 10 version, you can't play with the people on the Steam version and vice versa, which is potentially even bigger money grab. So shame on you, Activision.
Yeah, that's
shame on you. Not it's bad enough that you recycle the same formula every year, rip them off with the add-on map packs prior to releasing the new version, I might add.
Yeah.
You, on top of that, potentially make people buy multiple versions just to get the best out of the game. Not to mention that you can't buy Modern Warfare Remastered without buying Infinite Warfare. So again, shame on you, Activision. What's wrong? Okay.
It's alright, I can carry on.
I think we've covered most of our notes. Oh, in case you're wondering, the microphone's a Yeti by Blue Microphone, so there you go.
Which you've been after for a while.
I have been after this one for a long while, so...
And he got it because it was a milestone big birthday.
In other words, I turned 40, I'm now in a midlife crisis with involving games.
Well, what was your excuse before you turned 40?
Early life crisis involving games.
Pre-midlife.
I wasn't really big in the console gaming until the 360.
Yeah, that was before I...
That was before we got together.
Yeah. Before we got together.
It was a couple of years before we got together. Yeah. Well, I had the original Xbox and the GameCube beforehand, but I wasn't buying loads of games until the 360.
I had Game Boy.
You had Game Boy?
Mm-hmm. And Nintendo.
Okie dokie, well, I think that...
Which I think we've covered before.
I think, yeah, we covered. So, well, as in terms of return episode, after a long time, we've already touched on a few things. Obviously, there's a billion other things going on in the gaming world.
And hopefully next time we'll be a little bit more organised and try and concentrate a little bit more. Well,
isn't it what makes it, isn't it?
It is. We don't like to be too serious about anything.
No, of course not. And, and the Wii players will be returning.
Yay!
So, watch out for them. We just got to decide what game to play.
No, I've got one of them horrible trees that I don't like.
We just got to decide what game to play.
Yeah.
So, anyway, on that note, I think it's time to call us for this episode. And this will be a regular weekly thing, this show. I intend to.
We'll try.
Well, it's going to be more regular than it has been. You know, we'll be waiting another year before the next episode. Put it that way. So, what are you doing? Oh, he's getting up to the nasty bits.
You know I don't like these.
Try the axe. That's better.
Yeah, I know.
So we'll call this for this episode of the show. So, until next time, take care.
And keep it fun.
Yeah, you remember.
I did. I was nearly never.
Bye-bye.
Bye.